Namaskar, I'm Ashok Vyas, and welcome to this special edition of This Week with Padma Shri Dr. Sudhir Parikh. And Dr. Saab, I welcome you in this show. And what is it that you think when you connect yourself with news headlines from India? In terms of election and the kind of rhetoric and
I see. Well, at the moment, for last at least 1 week, everything is hitting up too much, and there is a kind of everybody. All candidate has lost their kind of cool sometimes some candidates even lost their civility, and that is not good sign. In democracy, in election, civility has to be maintained. The use of the language should be proper. Then we can call it that we are mature democracy. And I think everything is heating up. Obviously, it is expected because election seems to be coming to end, and they want to win. I mean, every party wants to win as much as many seats as they can, and it's very obvious.
So, Rajiv, the kind of world which you have in your mind in terms of civility, in terms of the kind of communication, dignified way of addressing each other, that seems to be non-existent at the moment. If you take it right from the campaign mounted by Congress President Chaukidar Chore, and there were visuals where Priyanka, Vadra, Gandhi making kids chant this slogan.
That is wrong, absolutely wrong. And so I think fault lies with all the parties equally. So it's hard to say who
correct.
Who is responsible for what? But I think hopefully kind of more wisdom and cool prevail, and after election we should all get together again to run the country under whoever wins, under leadership of either most likely Narendra Modi. But if even Narendra Modi has NDA more coalition government, so be it, as long as government performs next 5 years.
So either because indeed we love India very much, but we are not a part of that dynamic directly, so maybe we can in a detached way look at it coolly, calmly, and analyze
right.
It probably people who are there in the thick of the action, they are looking at it as do and die sort of situation.
Yes, of course, as I say, that everything hits up, and when election comes to kind of a closed election, not one-sided election, then there's more heating up kind of, and there's more emotional, they are charged, and that's why this kind of rhetoric you can hear.
Now let us focus few minutes on West Bengal. West Bengal Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee, who is addressed as Didi by Prime Minister, she didn't respond to him when he wanted to reach out to her in order to see how the natural calamity oriented relief work should continue. And then she ended up saying at one of her campaign rally that he's not my prime minister. How do you
I think that is unacceptable, because it doesn't matter who is your prime minister, I mean which party a prime minister belongs to. Once he is holding that position, everyone should respect as a prime minister. There is no question about it.
Absolutely, and there has been a lot of words, heated words exchanged. There was another video where she objected to some people chanting Jai Shri Ram. And though from your point of view, as we have discussed in this show, we feel that election should be above these religious
right.
divides, etc. But it seems as if it is very much in the center of the political discussion these days. And again, I bring to your attention this reference of Jai Shri Ram. So, should that be ignored, or should the other parties?
I mean, I'm not sure, because we don't know the 100% of the story.
Correct.
Because yesterday I was watching one news channel and somebody was denying it, that one of the spokesperson of the TMC was denying it, that Mamtaji didn't say this way, the way you are portraying it. It is BJP's version. So we don't know. But religion, as much as possible, there are two things. Religion should be out of picture. But if you cannot, because of the emotionally charged environment, if religion comes in the picture, one should ignore it a little bit.
So where should be the focus when we look objectively and ideally? The basic issue of India's growth, development, employment, foreign policy, etc., is not being debated in a civilized fashion.
Yeah, but that is kind of unfortunate thing, because that's the way what people are interested in it at the end of the day. So whether a person is a poor or rich, they all know how they're going to the election results will going to affect his life, whether and how the economy is going to fare, how the employment will happen. Farmer, interested in how their crop will be sold, and so forth, right? So it is very important that election has to be. But this is again is a kind of a catch 22 kind of thing.
Yes.
So I don't think that what is happening is also it's a height of the election, emotionally charged election, where jumla is normal.
Right. And this from Jammu Kashmir and West Bengal, these are the only two states where we have heard a lot of violence having taken place near polling booths.
Yeah, right. So that should not happen. I mean, that's no. Right.
Just staying where we are right now in terms of the race, lack of clarity as to who is going to be where and what, but comparing the position of Mamata Banerjee to Mayawati to Rahul Gandhi to Akhilesh Yadav, when you look at all these leaders who are in the opposition, and let me also bring Arvind Kejriwal here, because he also was a part of the potential Mahagathbandhan. So who appears to be strong?
I think, there is a rumor that probably if, say, opposition has a chance to form the coalition, then probably person like Sarad Pawar will be Prime Minister, one who is mature, who has experience, who has been there for a long time. And that's what may end up happening.
You know, this reminds me, and again, call them jumla or statements. So recently, referring to the candidature of his daughter, Sharad Pawar said that if she loses, there'll be riots. Now, that kind of statement coming from a seasoned leader.
That is also not good.
Yeah.
That is not also good. But I think most likely BJP will win, right, either with the absolute majority of themselves, or I think they may form the coalition, they have coalition partner right now. And if they need one or two more partners, I think once they win a certain number of seats, say 230 to 40 plus, then everybody will line up with them.
And also, as we are talking about Indian politics and recent happenings, I think Chief Minister of Delhi gets the credit for having been slapped in public domain maximum number of times. So recently, last week also, there was an instance of this kind. What do you make out of it? In terms of your analysis, because there are two versions.
No, well, I think again, I don't know about real incidents, what happened, because I missed that one. But anyone who does any violence or any assault in public is not acceptable in democracy.
Absolutely.
Yeah, that's a real answer to it.
Yeah, so that's an ideal answer. And allow me to share briefly, since you didn't see it. So there were some visuals where one guy jumped on the jeep, which is open jeep, and slapped him 2-3 times. And then police says that he's a disgruntled Aam Aadmi Party guy. Arvind Kejriwal says that he's a BJP guy, and he hit Arvind Kejriwal because of his statement criticizing Prime Minister regarding his relationship with Pakistan. So we don't know.
We don't know the facts. So it's hard to. But any violence is no no. Whether.
So very quickly, Dr. In the election debates, both parties are revisiting history in a way. But recently, Prime Minister Narendra Modi referring to Rajiv Gandhi, previous Prime Minister, Congress leader, as Bhrashtachari number one, it has caused different reactions from different people. Many people have felt offended. How do you see,
personally, I would not touch a person who is passed away.
Correct.
Because, I mean, in Hindu culture, we do not talk anything about a person who is not here. Or person even, forget about being passed away, but person who is not presence. Because you don't give any chance to him or her to defend him or herself. So, I think it's not very wise thing, or probably lot of people may not go well with a lot of people.
Right. So we'll see in terms.
But I'm not sure that it's significant comment anyway. It won't affect the election one way or other. So just is a non-event thing.
I agree with you. Yet what has happened is after that statement, all leaders of Congress are advocating in favor of Rajiv Gandhi, and they have reduced their rhetoric against Prime Minister Modi, Chaukidar Chore. So maybe there is some strategic thinking, I don't know about that. But as we conclude this program, at this point, your words for our viewers.
Well, I think elections are going well, and you can see that even though it's a long, 1 month long election, and still democracy is so vibrant and so versatile, that everybody is still taking part without any much really violence or without much any untoward incidents in 1 billion people. I think we must give credit to the voters of the India, those 900 million people, those who are voting.
Absolutely.
For that dedication to democracy, and God bless India, and God bless Indian democracy. And I'm sure that it will survive many, many, many centuries to come.
Wonderful. Thank you very much, Dr. Sudhir Parikh sir. Thanks to all of you for being with us.
And thank you. And thank you for joining me this week. And again, we'll see you next week. Till then, goodbye. Good night. God bless America. God bless India. Jai Hind. Thank you.
And now, time for weekly show with a passionate India lover. Chairman of ITV Gold and Parikh Worldwide Media. Get ready for loving sharing from physician, philanthropist, publisher, and India advocate in This Week with Padma Shri Dr. Sudhir Parikh.